Hi YouTube, my name is Kristen, I'm an aspiring author, and today I'm going to be doing the WIP or work in progress tag. This tag was originally created by Jessie Elliott, but her video has since been taken down. But if you do want to do this tag, I will be leaving the questions down below, and let me know if you do it because I would love to see it. Now I decided to do this video because I wanted to introduce you guys to the project that I am working on. If you watched last week's vlog, I talked about how I was shelving TMN for the time being and picking up this new project. And so I wanted to introduce you guys, kind of give you guys a gist of what I'm going to be working on. So question one is, what is the working title of your book? Now this one, I don't have a title for it yet, but my working titles are CWB, Creepy Woods Book, or Project Ravenwood. Those are kind of what I'm working with. The Ravenwood one, I probably won't be referring to it on video as much, just because I'm not sure if Ravenwood is what I'm going with for the town name, but that is the title so far. So yeah, subject to change once I actually come up with the title. Question number two is, where did the idea for this book come from? So I don't remember exactly like where this idea came from, what I was doing when I thought of it, because usually my ideas are sparked by some kind of media, like a book I'm reading or a movie I'm watching, etc. This one I don't quite remember what happened, but I do know I sent a text message on June 10th at 2:30 in the morning to Lindsay and was basically like, oh my god, I just got this idea. And at the end of the text message, after I like gave her all the ideas I just had, said, please dear god, let this writing motivation come back when it's not 2 a.m. because I'm tired but also very excited to maybe work on something soon. So that is where the idea came from, kind of. Question number three, what genre does this book fall under? Now this one I am sure is a YA compared to my last issue. So it's a YA, horror, because I'm a horror writer. And this one has like a little bit of like dark fantasy as well, which has been really fun. Question number four is to fan cast your characters for a potential movie in the future. I don't have actual actors except for maybe one of my characters that fit, so I'm just going to be showing you the Pinterest pictures that I have. So first I have my main character, Riley. She is 17. She is plus size. She wants to be a graphic novelist and is working on her art portfolio because she wants to major in art. And I love her so much. Next character I have is Nora. She is also 17 and she is autistic, and her current special interest that she's really, really into is mycology, or the study of mushrooms. She likes to go into the forest and study what she finds and just spends most of her time in the forest. And she is the granddaughter of Agatha, or Aggie, and she is Riley's aunt's next door neighbor. Aggie is like the grandmotherly character of my dreams. I love writing like grandma mentor characters because I have that with my grandmother. Like, she's like helped raise me with my mom, and so I have like a special place in my heart for grandmother characters. And so I love Aggie. She is sassy and tell it like it is, and so, so cool. Next I have Milo, and his name is subject to change. There's something about it doesn't quite fit right, but I haven't been able to find another name that I like just as much. So for now, he is Milo. He is 18 and he is also a senior in high school, just like the rest of them. And he works for the library. His mom is head librarian, and so he got a job over the summer working at the library as well. He is gay. He is black. He wants to move out of Ravenwood so bad because Ravenwood is this tiny, tiny town, and he just wants to live in the city, and he wants to get the hell out of Ravenwood as fast as possible for so many reasons, but mostly because he's just so sick of living in a small town. Next, I have more of the like side characters. So we have Riley's dad. He has a really, really close relationship with Riley, which I love, and I've been really interested in writing because I don't have that. And so it's very fun to kind of write a really close daughter-dad bond. Next, I have Riley's mom, who technically isn't even in the book, really, because she went missing when Riley was really, really young, but this is how I picture her. And then I also have Riley's aunt. This is Iris, and Iris is a little weird, and Iris has some secrets, but yes, Iris, this is perfectly what Iris would look like. I also have Milo's sister, and she is a couple years younger than the main characters, but she is like the popular girl, kind of mean, kind of snotty, and she has like a group of like the mean girl friends, and they kind of like run the town kind of thing. And then my final side character that I'm going to talk about, and that is Samara. And now Samara has escaped Ravenwood. She and her sister live in Portland, and they have to go talk to her at some point in the book. But yes, this is Samara. She runs a kind of metaphysical witchy store. Question 5. What is a one sentence synopsis of your book? Okay, give me a second. Okay, I wrote something out on my iPad. It's not one sentence. It's not good. But here's the gist. When Riley is invited to spend the summer in her presumed dead mother's hometown with the aunt she hasn't seen in years, she thinks it's the perfect chance to learn more about who her mom was and maybe find some inspiration for her art portfolio. But Ravenwood is full of secrets, and if Riley isn't careful, she might end up missing too. Yeah, that kind of helps. That kind of gives you the gist of what my book is. That wasn't good. Question 6, is this book going to be self-published or traditionally published? And my goal is traditional publishing. I think I've mentioned before that self-publishing seems like so much beyond my capabilities because you have to do everything and you are in charge of everything. And that just sounds like I'm never going to get anything done because I'm going to overthink everything. So yes, I wanted to be traditionally published. Question 7, how long did it take you to write the first draft? I started this on Tuesday, so I have not finished. My goal is to write a very, very quick draft and maybe take a couple weeks to a month to write the first draft, and then I can go back and edit it and make it better. But I just want to get the first draft out as fast as I can. Question 8, what other books would you compare to your book? So I have 3 books that comp for different reasons. The first of which is The Devouring Grey by Christine Lynn Herman. The second one is Harrow Lake by Kat Ellis. And the third one is When the Trees Crept In by Dawn Kurtigich. I love all 3 of those books, and for different reasons, they all comp pretty well. Question 9, what inspired you to write this book? So this book is kind of just like an amalgamation of all the things that I really wanted to write, and I just kind of created a plot so that I could use that. And so I've always wanted to write like a creepy woods book. I love that trope in fiction, and I've just always wanted to write my own. I wanted to write an autistic character, specifically one who was really into mushrooms, because that's been one of the things that I've been really interested in the past like 2 years. And so I've wanted to be able to incorporate that in some way. And then I also wanted to write a fat main character. I've never done that. And as a fat person, I would like to represent myself in fiction. And then there's so many other aspects that I just have always wanted to write or love writing, like just like the different relationships in the book. So it's just kind of like a book after my own heart. It is a book that I would like to read, and so I'm writing it. And question number 10, what are some other things that might pique a reader's interest? So other than things that I've already mentioned, there is a creepy ass monster that lives in the woods. There's mycology, which should be interesting to everybody, but probably is only interesting to like a niche group of people. But mushrooms are cool. It's also sapphic, and basically everyone is gay. So that is the WIP or work in progress tag. I hope you enjoyed hearing a little bit about what this project is that I'm working on. And let me know what you're working on down below. I'd love to hear it. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that good jazz. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Thank you.